We've also have before us Sean Ushijima, who is a former board member of the American Institute of Architects.
As introduced, I am a licensed architect in our community. I am a member of the Honolulu American Institute of Architects, known as the AIA, and a former board member of the Honolulu AIA. Let me begin by telling you that I am far from being an expert on rail. I will leave that to the experts here at hand. But I am a businessman who has a professional interest in the community that is in support of the long overdue elevated rail project. I am here with the support from colleagues in my profession who are also AIA members and whom also share the same views as I do. Some of us have had the privilege of working on the rail, some of us have not. I, for one, had the pleasure of working as a sub-consultant to a firm that specializes in transit design. Rail goes beyond the thinking of what is in it for me, what is in it for you. It goes beyond whether you live on the windward side or on the east side. It goes beyond political parties, political aspirations. Rail is about bettering our quality of life for everyone and the value it will bring to our community. It is about collaboratively working together to give our children and their children options in their lives. 2 years ago, the majority of voters voted for the elevated rail system. And with this vote, the city moved forward with the design and implementation of securing federal funding. Currently, colleagues of mine, who are also AIA members, were given the task to schematically design several stations. At each step along the way, they work collaboratively within the immediate neighborhoods to come up with the tasteful, appropriate designs. Not only do these designs reflect the context of which they are located, but more so, they bring to each neighborhood transit-oriented development with new retail and new commercial opportunities, revitalizing each neighborhood, creating desperately needed jobs, not to mention accomplishing its number one objective, to alleviate traffic on Oahu. Two springs ago, I was fortunate enough to visit Vancouver. There, they have an elevated rail system known as the Vancouver SkyTrain. I want to share several slides with you that will show not only the simplicity of the system, but you'll be able to see the scale of the system, the efficiency of the system, and more so, the safety aspect of the system. Here, you're able to see the SkyTrain crossing a major thoroughfare. And please note the relative scale of it to its surrounding context. Next slide. This is an aerial view of the SkyTrain running parallel with the major thoroughfare. You're able to see how the supports, the columns, fall in between the traffic flow, how the elevated train is able to pass vehicular traffic and not conflict with traffic lights and pedestrian circulation. Next slide, please. Station designs, like I previously mentioned, can be tasteful and blend in with its surrounding context. Here are designs that are under construction up in Vancouver. Next slide. Another station design under construction. Next. Lastly, with the collaborative work between the community, the city, the architects, and the engineers, we'll be able to design an aesthetically appealing elevated rail project. I'd like to end on a note that was repeated many times by my former coach, the late Eddie Hamada. My mentor, my friend, always addressed us in tight situations by saying success will be measured when preparation meets opportunity. The city has done its preparation, so let's not lose this golden opportunity. Thank you.